One of my favourite things I like about a service is the children's address. And this morning I want to talk about a rather colourful man. Now, Trafalgar Square is one of the most famous places in London. There is a big tall column of Admiral Horatio Nelson, Lord Nelson, who won the Battle of Trafalgar in 1805. So Lord Nelson is perched high on the column, surveying all he can see. But there is another statue hidden underneath the square, who hardly anybody knows about, but who is equally as interesting in his own way. Now this statue is of a road sweeper, and it is in the crypt of the Church of St. Martin in the Fields, which is part of the square. The statue is of a man called Henry Croft, and it stands in the furthest, most obscure corner of the church crypt. If you go in the church and go downstairs into the crypt, underneath the square, you will find a very busy cafeteria, a gift shop, a bookshop, a brass rubbing centre, and an art gallery. But far away from all these things, in the quiet corner of the crypt, is the statue of Henry Croft. And here he is. And as you can see, he's rather small. Now it is an unusual statue. It looks, someone said, like he was standing waiting for a bus. It is life-size, but not very tall, even though it is wearing a top hat, because Henry Croft was only 5 foot tall. If you look closely at the statue, you can see that all over his clothes are tiny little circles. And these, would you believe, are buttons, because Henry Croft was the first of what is called the Pearly Kings. Now his story is very interesting. He was born in a workhouse in London in 1861 and sadly died in the same place in 1930. His father was a musician, but when he died, Henry was brought up in an orphanage and at the age of 15 started work as a road sweeper. Now this is something that he did for the rest of his life, during which he got married and had 12 children. But because he had himself had been brought up in an orphanage, he decided that he wanted to do something for other people. He started to sew pearl buttons onto his clothes and invented the idea of the Pearly King and Queen. He used his costume to help raise money for charities, particularly for hospitals. His first suit, which dates from about 1880, was what was called a smother suit, one where the whole of the fabric is covered by many thousands of buttons. He is thought to have created 7 suits for himself, as well as suits for others, and a range of pearly hats, caps, belts, ties, and a large overcoat using more than 30,000 buttons and weighing approximately 25 kilograms. Now I find this totally amazing, because if a button comes off in my house, it stays off. The ability to sew passed me by. So how this man could have done what he did, I really find amazing. But Henry is regarded as the person who created this idea of pearly kings and queens. And by the year 1911, there were 28 pearly king and queens spread across all the boroughs of London. They use their magnificent costumes to help to raise money, and Henry was thought to have raised around £5,000 in his lifetime, which is the equivalent of about £200,000 today. An amazing amount to be raised by someone who worked as a road sweeper. In those days, people who did extraordinary things for charity were sometimes awarded ribbons and medals for their work. And it is claimed Henry was awarded in excess of 2,000 of these for his charitable work. In June 1907, he was invited to the Horse of the Year show in Olympia, and on this occasion was presented to King Edward VII and Queen Alexandra. When he died in 1930, his funeral cortege was over half a mile long, with more than 400 Pearly king and queens in attendance. His statue was originally placed near his grave in a cemetery in London, but later it was moved to St. Martin the Fields in Trafalgar Square. So if you go to London and go to see Nelson's column, also give a thought for Henry Croft, whose statue is underneath the square in the crypt, residing as it does at the very heart of London in Trafalgar Square, beneath the streets that he once swept, all dressed up in his top hat and Pearly suit. Now, I am sure a nightingale does not sing too often in Trafalgar Square. However, it does in Berkeley Square. So over to Jack.